All right, so this video is just a short little glib information. I don't know if I can include it with the slideshow, but this is about the canine dog training school that my mother went to when she was, close to like 8 months before she died, before she passed away. And so it's kind of important, it's important to, the ledger of life, that she was actually able and skilled enough to do that, to go to such a training. And it was an intensive training school with absolute, like, I think it was just 2 weeks, but 2 weeks of intense study, 2 weeks of intense learning about dogs, about all of their problems, and yet at the same time training. So you take the dog with you to this school, you live there with the dog, you train with the dog, and yet you also study everything, all the way to heartworm, etc. So yeah, it's quite an intense school. It's the canine school, and I'm going to advertise it a little. She went awfully late in her life, because really the gist of the school is for, if you're going to be a professional, open up your own dog training school or whatever, and you can understand, and you can see the difference immediately after. However, dogs do resort back to their old ways, even with the training, even with such intensive training. You know, there are certain stubborn qualities to just say no, you know. So when they leave their particular master, I'll say, when they leave that particular master, they do run amok with their old ways, because it's just something they just learned, you know what I mean? So they slide back into their old fashion. And the dog she took was Rudy, was not this one, it was Rooskie, the Siberian. But yeah, he was great apparently in certain respects, and in other respects terrible. And it's a tough training school where you actually take the dog by the leash, and you have to drag it in a circle and do all of these things on the ground, do these real intense, and the dog has to follow. It has to follow everything. So I don't know. I don't know how she did it, but it's, yeah, in very intense school. And I want to congratulate all of her peers also. So that's all the next video is. It's going to be a slideshow of them at the school. And what can I say with training, dog training, aside from we need more of it, because the untrained dogs, they end up in the streets, and they hurt people, they hurt each other. You know, we can't have untrained dogs, because people hate them. People hate them. They get attacked. They attack children, they attack adults, they're unmannered, they jump on you when they shouldn't, blah blah blah, you know, all of this is going on. So you cannot have untrained animals. So, you know, and then so we're like, well, we love dogs, don't we? We love animals, we love them. But there's a certain point where the human species is just like, no, that dog has just gone too wild, it's just too wild, I can't handle it. You know, and so they end up in backyards, and then they end up more and more in the disgusting realm of guard dog duty, when they're just out there in the back garden on a leash, or just there unattended like their whole lives. So yeah, dog training means the dog is there with you by your side when you want, as your particular companion. That was the intent of dog training, was to be your dog companion. So, yeah, instead of a visitor that just is there, that you have to feed. So, anyway, congratulations to all of them. And no, she didn't bring this one, but he is a cutie. I believe his name is Hoss, an old Samoyed named Hoss, one of the greatest dogs, from one of those great lines. I'm not sure the line itself, but it was a pedigree. Yeah, beautiful dog.